Welcome to the Homeworld training mission. This tutorial will cover the user interface, camera control, unit selection, and movement. Our first priority is the taskbar. The taskbar provides you with a variety of information about what you currently have selected and provides you easy access to basic commands. Click OK to continue.
Hello and welcome to Homeworld Remastered. My name is P52 Smith. Today we're going to be starting off by running through the tutorial missions for Homeworld Remastered, because it's been a while since I've played this properly and I want to make sure I know what I'm doing before we get into this. So first of all, we have to click OK to continue, because we've been told the taskbar provides you the right information. I think it's the bottom.
You can minimize the taskbar by clicking on the flashing icon or pressing backspace. Do this now.
So that's the little bit at the bottom here. So if we hit backspace, that goes away.
Back, keep pressing backspace. Do this now.
Okay. Ah, it's all gone away. Ah!
Good job. The recall window displays all previous speech in the mission. Click on the recall icon to display all previous speech in the mission.
That seems a useful button.
To exit the recall window, click close.
Okay.
Throughout the game, objectives will be assigned to you. Objectives give you information on what you must accomplish in each mission. Click OK to continue.
Okie dokie.
You have just been issued a new objective.
Ooh.
To access the objective screen, click on the flashing icon. Do this now. Good job.
Thank you.
This is the objectives screen. Click the Learn How to Play Homeworld objective to get more information on it. To exit the objective screen, click on the close button.
And that's your depth, right? Attain a basic military camera control, unit selection, and movement. That seems useful.
To issue orders, you must first select the ships you want to command. Click OK to continue.
Okie dokie.
Left click on the scouts to select them.
Reporting.
Scouts selected. New reinforcements available. A second scout squadron is launching. To select multiple squadrons, first hold down the left mouse button and then drag a box around both scout squadrons. Do this now. This is called drag selecting.
Ready.
Excellent work.
Thank you.
OK to continue. Notice that the taskbar has been updated with your selection.
Yes,
it has. The taskbar lists all currently selected ships. Ships can be selected by left-clicking, drag-selecting, and by clicking on the ship icon in the taskbar.
Uh-huh.
In order to master space combat, you must first learn how to control the camera. At this point, the camera is focused on a squadron of scouts. Click OK to continue.
It is indeed.
Hold down the right mouse button and move the mouse to rotate the camera. Do this now. Excellent work. Click OK to continue.
Space. Ooh, pretty space.
Continue practicing camera rotation. When you are ready to move on, click OK.
I mean, that's some pretty stuff. Okay, this game has been remastered and re-released relatively recently, but it's still effectively an old game. So to have that level of gorgeousness designed in an old level game, that's pretty good. Okay.
To zoom the camera, scroll the mouse wheel, or hold down both mouse buttons while moving the mouse forwards and backwards. Practice camera zooming.
Ooh, that's
good
funky.
Work.
I'll stick with scroll wheel.
When you are ready to continue, click OK.
Okie dokie.
To pan the camera, move the mouse cursor to the edge of the screen. Do this now.
Okay, I can't do the right edge.
Excellent.
Okay.
Click OK to continue.
So I have a second monitor to the right, and the mouse just jumps off the edge, so I gotta watch out for that.
The arrow keys on the keyboard also pan the camera. Now, pan the camera until the scouts are no longer in view.
Right arrow, easy.
Click OK to continue, or keep practicing camera panning.
No, I think we got this.
To focus the camera on a ship, press the middle mouse button or use the focus key. This snaps the camera to the currently selected ship. In this case, the scouts. Excellent work.
To focus on an unselected ship, I didn't do that, but okay.
Hold down the Alt key and left click on the object. Try this now. The next topic is the sensors manager. To activate the sensors manager, press spacebar or click on the sensors icon on the taskbar.
Here we go.
The Sensors Manager allows you to see the game world from a much greater distance and is used for strategic movement and command of ships. Click OK to continue.
So this is where we'll be spending a certain amount of time in the game, this extra wide view.
The two green dots represent the two scout squadrons. From the Sensors Manager, you can see distant objects such as these asteroids.
Yep.
The Sensors Manager also displays objective information. Click OK to continue. Camera control and ship selection work as normal in the Sensors Manager. All ships have a tactical overlay, or TO for short. TOs help identify friendly and enemy targets. Click OK to continue. Friendly ships will have green TOs. Enemy targets will have red TOs. Allies have yellow TOs. Click OK to continue.
Right, now you'll see that we have blue TOs. That's because I have enabled the colorblind mode, which puts blue for yourself, red for enemies still. I'm not sure what it does for allies. I've not seen the allies in this yet, so we'll find out. But it makes them much more distinct colors, because me differentiating that yellow and that green is... No, not going to happen. So, we've done this way.
Tab cycles through all various TO settings. Some settings display more information than others. Experiment using the camera in the Sensors Manager now. To return to the normal view, press spacebar.
So, we've got a minimal setting, a basic setting, and a full-on setting. I like the full-on setting. So, yeah, as you know, so this bluish sphere around these ships is where we can see. As you can see, there's a line on the plane showing us where that is on the plane, and you see the orb around it in 3D space, what we can see above and below, which is useful to know. Alright, let's get on with this.
We will now cover ship movement. To effectively command your fleet, you must learn how to navigate 3D space. Click OK to continue.
Sounds like a good idea to me.
First, select a scout squadron. Remember, you can left-click or drag-select the desired ships.
Copy.
Now, right-click on this group of asteroids to issue a right-click move command.
Course set.
Well done. Right-click movement orders a ship to move to a specified landmark. For example, another ship, an asteroid, or a piece of debris. Remember, you can rotate and zoom the camera while issuing a move command. Click OK to continue.
Okie dokie. Oops. Missed.
The scouts have reached their destination.
Good.
Ships can also be moved to any point in space.
That sounds
click
useful.
OK to continue. To use the movement disk, right-click on empty space or press the movement hotkey, M. Do this now. Good work. The movement disk represents the current plane the selected unit is on. Right-click on a desired location to issue a move order.
To bring them back towards our carrier.
To its target destination. The next lesson will cover vertical movement. While right-click movement covers most situations, vertical movement is needed to gain tactical advantages. Click OK to continue. Bring up the Sensors Manager.
Okay.
Notice the ping on the map is above the world plane. The world
yes, it
plane
is
the horizontal disk at the center of the map. Click OK to continue. Now, bring up the movement disk by right-clicking on empty space or pressing the movement hotkey. To raise or lower the destination point, hold down the left mouse button and move the mouse up or down. Order one of your ships to move to the ping on the map using the 3D movement.
So that needs to go good to there.
This concludes this tutorial.
Hey!
Using the camera, selecting ships, and issuing move orders. When you're ready to move on, click OK to proceed to the next tutorial.
I think we're happy enough with spinning the camera around. You can see now with the Sector Scout group we've got this second sensors bubble coming out, like I described earlier. So yeah, excellent. We can move, we can order, time to move on.
This tutorial will cover resourcing, shipbuilding, and combat. To build ships and research new technology, you will need to harvest resources.
Okay.
Resources can be gathered from asteroids and salvage containers. Click OK to continue. To harvest, select the resource collector and right-click on the indicated asteroid. Do this now.
Okay.
Ready.
Resource collector and asteroid.
Collection
excellent
confirmed.
Additionally, pressing the Harvest hotkey, H, will order selected resource collectors to harvest nearby resources.
That's useful.
OK to continue. Production ships, like this carrier, can build ships. Click the build button, B, to open the build manager.
Oh, we can press the button up here.
The currently displayed menu shows the available fighter-class ships that can be built. Click OK to continue.
Yep. So, fighters, scouts.
Click on the scout icon to begin construction of a scout squadron. Notice how the progress bar increases, indicating the status of the current build task.
Yep, that's going up. I like this bit. No,
click
he just talks
the
there.
Click on the research button, or the research hotkey, R, to activate the research manager.
Research.
This is the research manager. Notice that enhanced scout sensor technology is available for research. This improves scout sensors. Click OK to continue. Click on enhanced scout sensors to research enhanced scout sensors.
Fair enough.
Each research item will unlock new build or research options to enhance your ships. Deciding what to research or upgrade is critical for victory. Click OK to continue.
There's no OK! Presumably you have to wait for this research to take up. Meanwhile, we watch this resource collector do his thing.
Scout sensor research complete. Stand by to begin combat lessons. A squadron of bombers has been constructed, and an unarmed torpedo frigate has been provided. Click OK to continue.
Okay. So we've got some fighting units, and we've got an unarmed torpedo frigate.
To attack a target, select the bomber squadron and right-click on the torpedo frigate. Order the bombers to attack the torpedo frigate now.
Let's get all involved. Fire!
Frigate, prepare for assault. Enemy is collided. Awaiting
order. To attack multiple enemies, hold down control and use the left mouse button to drag select a group of targets. Attack the three frigates now.
Okie dokie.
Strike group, prepare for assault.
Come on, guys. Shoot him already.
Congratulations.
Thank you.
You now understand all the basics required to play Homeworld.
Woohoo!
This tutorial covers control groups, special actions, and advanced commands. Control groups allow you to select a group of ships and assign them to one of the 10 number keys. Click OK to continue.
Okie dokie.
First, select the three squadrons of interceptors.
Done.
Now press the control key and the number 1 at the same time to assign the interceptors to group 1. You have now assigned that group to the number 1.
Yay.
From now on, pressing the number 1 key or clicking on the 1 icon on the taskbar will select group 1. Click OK to continue. Pressing the number 1 twice will also focus the camera on the interceptors. Up to 10 groups can be assigned, each corresponding to one of the number keys.
Okay.
Now assign the newly arrived bombers to group 2.
So, bombers.
Reporting.
Group excellent.
Two.
Now, order Group 2 to attack the enemy frigate that is just hyperspaced in.
Strike group, prepare for assault.
Group 2 reports victory. Well done. The next lesson covers special actions. Special actions vary from ship to ship. The carrier that has just arrived has a cloaking generator.
Ooh.
To use special actions, first select the carrier.
Copy.
This tab displays all special actions. Currently, only the cloak ability icon is active. Press the cloak icon to activate the carrier's cloak generator.
Cloaking
special
sale active.
Special actions are also activated via the shift menu. To access the shift menu, hold down shift and right-click on a ship or empty space. Using either the special actions commands icons on the taskbar or the shift menu, order the carrier to decloak.
So if we do... Ooh, we've got to hold down a shift. We can let go shift once we click. Okay. So orders. Special cloak.
Cloak field disengaged.
Okay.
Unlike cloak, some special actions require a target. This marine frigate is one such example. Marine frigates are used to capture enemy ships. To capture an enemy ship, select the marine frigate and right-click on the enemy frigate. You can also use the capture icon or the shift menu.
Copy.
So that executes a capture instruction.
En route. Capture target acquired. Stand by for insertion. Marines going in.
Okay, maximum tactical overlay enabled. Way I like it. How's that progress doing? About halfway there.
Light resistance. Let's finish this. Good work,
well
people.
Done.
The bridge is ours.
Tactics will be covered next.
Okay.
Idle ships will default to their tactics setting. Tactics govern how ships react to the enemy targets. Click OK to continue. Units set on aggressive will retaliate against all enemy targets. Ships on defensive will defend friendly ships but will not pursue enemy targets. This is the default tactic. Passive tactics order units to stand down. They will not engage the enemy under any circumstances. Tactics will also change the formations ships use. Click OK to continue. To change tactics for selected ships, click on the desired tactic on the taskbar. You can also use the tactics hotkeys.
Okay.
Strike groups are tactical formations of ships designed to support each other in battle. Click OK to continue. Drag select all of these ships.
Done.
Now, select a strike group formation from the strike group rollout on the taskbar.
So we've got capital phalanx. These aren't any capital ships. Frigate line or frigates. Fighter screen, yep. Or a delta formation. Broad. X. Claw. Wall. And sphere. Let's try claw.
New formation acknowledged.
You seem to have broken into a couple of claws, but okay.
New formation acknowledged.
Well done. Strike groups are more efficient than the collection of their parts. However, you will notice that a strike group will only travel as quickly as its slowest unit. Therefore, a strike group is a trade-off between speed and efficiency. Waypoints allow you to move your ships along specified paths. This can be used to move around asteroid fields or to set up sneak attacks. Click OK to continue. Click on the waypoint icon, hotkey W, to enter waypoint mode. While in this mode, you can queue a series of move commands. Your ships will move to each destination point in sequence. Practice this now. Waypoints can also be used to issue common commands such as attack or harvest. However, once a command is issued, the waypoint path ends at that point. To end the waypoint, simply click on the waypoint icon, the hotkey W, or press escape.
Waypoint confirmed.
And away they go. I mean, that's not something you want to see bearing down on you as an enemy ship.
You have now successfully completed Woohoo! The final tutorial for Homeworld. If you wish to practice these skills, you will be confronted by ever-increasing Vigor strike forces.
Ooh. Okay, can I build some more stuff? Yes, I can.
Assembly underway.
We could do with some resource collectors.
Assembly underway. Roger.
Let's put them into a group that we can organize. Any of these enemies? No. Good. Right, what I want to do then is bring everybody
ready
over here.
Underway. Strike group coordinates locked in.
So that we can get our
resource collector complete.
Resource collectors on these resources. So we'll spend a little bit of time pigging through these.
Carrier fighter facility complete.
New fighters available for construction.
Roger. Collection confirmed. Ready.
Ah, that thing can't move. Aww. Thanks, game.
Ready.
Well, I guess we'll just lose that then.
Reporting. Reporting.
Carrier is moving slowly. Another resource collector. Good.
Confirmed. Resources locked in.
No sign yet of the enemy.
Ready.
Come on, carrier.
Destination locked in.
Resource collector complete.
Thank you.
Standing by. Green line confirmed. Collection confirmed.
Oh, there's some enemies.
Group 5. Moving to intercept.
Group 5 assigned.
Standing by.
Resource collector complete.
Strike group under enemy attack. Group 5 copies.
Group 1 reports victory.
Watch your 6, drawing heavy fire.
Group 1 reports enemy contact.
Status report.
Group 1 under attack.
Strike group to
attack
battle.
Attack them!
Please.
All stations reported by the numbers.
Stay sharp.
I think some of them are in idle mode. Not very helpful. Cool. Let's reorganize them around the capital ship.
Resource collector complete.
Or the frigate, rather. Idle resource collector, go.
Collection confirmed.
Idle resource collector, go.
Resources locked in. Group 1.
Let's get
docking
them to repair.
Group 2 reporting. Docking with carrier.
Actually, scratch that.
Strike group reports hostile contact. Group 5 standing by.
We're under fire.
Strike group under enemy attack.
Light That's the button I wanted.
Strike group to battle positions.
Assume combat stations.
Docking already forgotten the instructions.
Hold formation. Let's keep it together now. Contact confirmed.
Confirmed. Supporting friendly units. Stay sharp.
Where's the escort? We need cover here.
Strike group under enemy attack. Group 5 copies.
I'm taking hits here. I caught one.
Cabin pressure dropping.
Frigate lost.
No, yeah, well, it couldn't do anything.
We've got enemy
so.
Contact. Strike group reports hostile contact. Strike group attack order confirmed. Group 5 standing by. Strike group, prepare for assault.
Oh, more enemies.
Roger. Berths are clear. Assembly underway.
Let's get some more units out. I don't think we can build anything else. We can do a research module, but I think that's going to be a bit silly.
Strike group reports hostile contact. Group 5. New formation acknowledged.
Attack everything.
Strike group reports hostile contact. Local resources exhausted. Fleet moving on. Marine frigate heavily damaged.
Uh-oh.
Roger. We're drawing heavy fire.
Taking damage, fleet.
Interceptor squadron complete.
That's not good.
Carrier under attack.
Group 5 standing by. Ready. Strike group receiving fire.
Group 5 reinforced.
Supporting friendly units.
Okay, that's a lot
Strike
of enemies.
Group attack order confirmed. Strike group under enemy attack. Construction underway. Target entered a dust cloud. They're off our sensors. Strike group reports hostile contact.
Fire, requesting orders. Under attack, what's the call?
Fire! Fire everything!
Strike group under enemy attack. Under fire, requesting orders.
Bomber squadron, complete.
Under attack, what's the call?
Target entered a dust cloud. They're off our sensors. Strike group under enemy attack.
Copy.
Group 5, reinforced.
Strike group to battle positions. New formation acknowledged.
Okay, we're getting overrun now. This is getting silly.
Copy. Target entered a dust cloud. They're off our sensors.
There's no way we're going to win this, so I think we'll have time to call it there.
Squadron complete.
Next time we'll move on to some actual missions.
Heavy fire confirmed.
Until then, my days. I've been P50G Smith, you've been watching. Thank you very much, and goodbye.
Drawing heavy fire. Under fire. Requesting orders.
Stabilizers offline. Strike group receiving fire.
Under attack. What's the call? Heavy fire confirmed.
Group 1 defeated.
Resource collector under attack.